Sapphire PrismaLens is a beautiful new video filter from Boris Effects. It's designed to replicate shooting through physical prisms, reflect, refract, and catch light in surprising ways to create cinematic, dreamy looks. PrismaLens has three initial styles to choose from: single, linear, and radial. Each one gives you unparalleled freedom to design the perfect look for your shot. Harness the power of Mocha built directly in the plugin to track your shot or create wild custom shapes. There's a lot to explore, so why not experiment with a preset? The preset library is always a great place to get inspiration or find the look you want. Find one you like and make any tweaks or animate it up. Sapphire PrismaLens is great for music videos, travel logs, opens, social media, basically anywhere you need to create uniquely beautiful and eye-catching images. Go straight to borisfx.com now to learn about Sapphire and PrismaLens, or hang out with me a bit longer as we start to explore this effect on a few shots. And we're going to start out in After Effects, although all the things I'm going to show you with PrismaLens works in whatever host you're using Sapphire in, and we're going to take a look at a couple of other hosts later on as well. So the first thing to do is apply PrismaLens, which is found in the Stylize category. And these are the default parameters. If we have our effect selected, we can use the on-screen widgets to reposition where the reflection is, or change the source position, and we can even change how the sparkles are looking as well. Play that back. Let's have a quick overview of the parameters now to see what PrismaLens is doing. It's actually broken down into several modules, and I'm just going to ignore the first quarter of these because these are mainly to do with setting stuff up. What I'm interested in at the moment is reflection shape and reflection details and the differences between those. Reflection shape sets up how that prism shape looks. So we can do things like change rotation up, change up the size, change the number of sides, and as we did before, also change the position of where that shape is on the screen. Now, reflection details is all about what's shown in that shape. So we have things like opacity, so we can fade things on and off, and we choose what's being reflected with the source position, which we also saw a little bit earlier just by controlling the widget here. And we can update things like the Z distance and add a bit more rotation to this as well if needs be. Or even just flip the whole thing vertically or horizontally. Moving down the list, color correction affects the image within the shape. Chromatic aberration changes the chromatic aberration on the shape here, and we can, you know, do some funky things with changing shift position. I'll just leave that back at where it was previously. We can add in some of Sapphire's lovely glow, or add a tint to the reflection to make it look like it's being shot through coated glass, and we can change all of that stuff up here. So we can take that really, really wild, or take it down to zero and get a regular reflection there. Lights we'll come back to in just a moment, but those are the sparkles that we see. So we can easily simplify or add to what our PrismaLens looks like. Let's take a look at our next clip now in Premiere Pro. And we have our default PrismaLens set up right here. Let's look at the area of the parameters we ignored last time. And under the effect type, we actually have three different types of PrismaLens available. We have single, we have linear, and we have radial. Now we can see those three are different, but it can be a little bit tricky to see exactly what's happening just by changing that effect. So I always like to start with a preset. So if I go to load preset, and that loads in our preset browser, and we can see the presets down here. And flipping through here, we can see some of the looks we can get using PrismaLens. And I want to show you the linear preset so we can filter these out just by typing in linear. And I'll start with the angled linear fade. And let's scrub us over so we can see a little bit of a better frame. So in the parameters, we can see that the effect is now set to prism lens linear. And if we look at the reflection shape, this looks exactly the same as it did previously. But underneath it, we have a few more options opened up to us. We have the number of copies that we have. We can just scrub that up and that goes up to a maximum of 10. Let's take this down again. We have the angle at which that's being reflected out at. So let's keep that around about where it was. And we can change up things like the distance, which is the distance between the reflections, and the start offset, which is the distance that the reflections start at from the center. So we can leave a nice little gap in the center, nice little clean gap in the center there. And bias will move those reflections or bias those reflections to one side or the other. We also have opacity fade and size fade. So with both of these set to zero, every copy is going to be exactly the same as the original. If we change the opacity fade, we're going to start getting the outer copies fading out the further they are from the center. And same with the size fade. If we have this going in a positive way, the copies are going to get smaller. And we have this set in a negative way, the copies are going to get bigger as they move further away from the center. So this can give us some really nice effects. Now, of course, all of this can be animated. So if I grab my position widget, set a keyframe over at the first frame, and then I can just move and animate this over either by using the widgets or by changing things up in the parameters. And there we have the first steps to a more interesting animation. And obviously you can take this further and create something even more special. Let's take a look at our next shot now in DaVinci Resolve. And in Resolve, we have our clip loaded in, Sapphire Prism Lens applied to the clip, and let's start again with a preset. Now I want to take a look at the radial presets this time, so I'm just going to type in radial. And we have a few different ones to choose from, but I'll start with the big one, multi-row radial sparkles. And looking over at the parameters on this one, we can see that the mode we're working with here is set to prism lens radial. And we have basically the same types of parameters as we saw with the linear, except if we come down here, we have, instead of the linear copies, we have radial copies. And because we're doing reflections around a circle, we have things like the start angle and the total angle. We also have rows as well, so we can set up multiple rows of reflections, and this goes up to 3. But the rest of the controls work as they did with linear. But with this example, I want to have a look at some of the more advanced features, and one of those is the integration with Mocha. So if I click on Edit Mocha, it's going to bring me into the Mocha interface where we can do masking and tracking. So instead of hand animating a lot of this stuff, we can let motion tracking do the work for us. And we have 4 different tracking points set up. We have light pivot, which I don't really care about at the moment, so I'm going to turn off the cog to stop it from tracking and turn off the visibility to stop it from showing up. We have light start position. I'm just going to drag this over up into the corner by this light over here. We have position, which is obviously where the center of the prism lens is going to be. And with this one, I'm going to track the head. And we have source position, which I'm just going to turn off as well, so we don't need to worry about that right now. I don't care about rotation for either of these, so I'm just going to turn off rotation in the track motion options and track backwards. And then track forwards afterwards. So now I have nice tracking points going for the position and the source position. And what I'll do is I'll just place this blue crosshair in the exact position that I want the Mocha tracker data to be in. So let's save that and let's exit. And you'll see that by default, nothing actually changes. That's because we need to tell PrismaLens to use the position data, and we'll go down to the lights as well, because of course we need to tell it to use the lights position Now, I mentioned at the beginning of the tutorial that these sparkles are controlled by the lights. So if we come down in here into light, we can control things like the light's brightness, their size, and we can crank this up quite high if we want to have these big soft sparkles, or take the size down really low and you get these little bits of glitter. But I find this works probably best between 1 and maybe max 3, depending on what you want to do. And instead of always having to animate the light either using the start position or the pivot point, we can use shift speed X and Y to get some auto animation on here as well. So it just gives us a little bit of movement going between frames. And personally, I like to keep these at quite low values because otherwise it can get a little bit distracting. Now, the final secret behind these lights lies within the Edit Lights button. If I click on this, PrismaLens is going to start up the flare designer. Yeah, so what's actually driving these glints is the Sapphire Lens Flare engine. So if you know how to work the Sapphire Lens Flare engine, you're going to be in good stead here. And we can turn off excess elements that we don't need and just leave ourselves with some much more sparsely looking glints. Of course, we can add some more in there as well if we want to. So to get back to the default lens flare, all we do is we search under all for prism. And there's a preset called PrismaLens Glints 01, and that will be the default glints that we have normally within the effect. We can also use Mocha to create masks, either to drive the shape or just to mask where the effect is being applied. So let's just turn off the visibility on my effect trackers there. And I'm going to come up to my X-spline and I'm just going to draw a loose shape around the bottom of the screen. I right click to close that shape off and just adjust that area there. And I'll call this one Effect Mask. I don't have to rename it, it's just for my sake. So let's save that again, exit out of here. And when we come back in, it will now only show the effect where our Mocha mask was. And if I open up Mocha here, I can add softness at this point, or we can add softness directly in Mocha. And we can choose how we use that mask, using this drop down here, and we have some more advanced techniques for mixing and matching what these elements are doing. And this is why I always counsel that you should look through the presets, because the presets themselves contain a lot of these more interesting techniques for you to take a look at and explore yourself. And if we play that back, we start to see our PrismaLens effect being animated by Mocha and constrained by a Mocha mask. So PrismaLens is a fun and deep effect, and there are loads of different effects that you can start to create with it. And because it's modular, you can just turn off the modules you don't want and focus on the ones you do. And like all Sapphire effects, the most creative effects come through play and exploration. So to learn more about PrismaLens and Sapphire in general, head on over to boriseffects.com, where you can also download a free trial version of the software and find full information about the different license types that we have available. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'll see you again soon. Remember, boriseffects.com also has a treasure trove of free tutorials. So if you want to learn about a specific effect or how professionals are using them in the field, take a look at the video section of boriseffects.com.